Hello everyone, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Thank you for confirming. So hello, good afternoon. I'm Dr. Swati here from Trainers Club, and I welcome all of you who joined on time, though there are so many who want to join and may join in between. But by keeping all of your time in mind and you joined on time, I think we should start at least by giving the introduction of our speaker today. Manish is coming third time with us, though he has already delivered two sessions with us, which is related to storytelling, part one and part two. A quick intro that Manish about Manish. Manish is a certified access consciousness bars practitioner, master trainer. Do train the trainer and diploma holder in NLP. He is also an NLP professional with an overall work experience of 7 years with him. Have been majorly a part of e-commerce industry. His core area of interest lies in leadership and communication, and is extremely passionate about storytelling and extremely focused with regards to the learning on continuous basis and transforming individuals by means of facilitation, coaching, and mentoring. So that's a brief about Manish. And personally, what I know is a wonderful person, fun-loving. He make all of us laugh in the session. And I believe today also we will enjoy his session. And though the topic is also a lovely topic of voice modulation, so I'm sure he will do a justice with this topic. And I just welcome Manish and request him to initiate the session.
Thank you so much, Dr. Swati, for the nice introduction and for the great introduction, in fact. And hello, everyone. Good afternoon. And I welcome you all for this session on Essence of Voice Modulation in Communication. And I'm really glad that on a Sunday afternoon also, all of you have taken your time out to attend this session. I'm really honored and I'm really thankful and grateful to all of you for making taking your time out to attend this. Swati ma'am, can I just share the screen?
Yeah, sure.
Is my screen visible to all of you?
Not yet, but it will come, I think. It's scanning is going on.
Yeah, is it? I think, yeah, this is fine. I think it has come now. Okay. So, yes, I'll start now with this. I think my screen is here currently. Now I will be starting this session with a small activity. So this is my first thing that I will start the session itself with an activity, and I request all the participants to ensure that they participate a lot, because this is going to be a two-way communication session and I want active participation from all the participants who are present here. And it would be really great and really fun if we have an interactive session. And so I'm just starting the topic itself with an activity. So the activity is as such.
Manish, I'm sorry to interrupt.
Yes.
But I cannot see the screen. So I also want to check with everyone. So whether they'll be able to see the screen or not.
Okay. Can you see the screen now?
No, we're not able to see the screen.
No. It hasn't come yet.
Swati, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ravi. Please tell me.
Yeah.
Can you see the screen now?
Just give me 5 minutes. I'll be back again.
No, sir.
Okay.
Sure, Ravi.
Yeah.
Is it visible now?
Yes, yes.
Okay, fine. So I'm just going to start with an activity first. So the activity here, it says, read the following in a flat tone without using any voice modulation. So before jumping into what actually voice modulation is, so let's read out certain things without, you know, using any sort of voice modulation, and let's see how it goes by. Okay, so I'm just going to have this over here. So I want any participant to come and at least read this. Whatever the things are here, you can just read it out, but do not read it as per whatever is mentioned here. Read it in a very flat and dull tone. Anyone can just start reading this.
Can I read?
Yes. Your name, sir?
My Anil Mahajan.
Anil. Anil. Thank you so much. Yeah, Anil. Yeah,
I think you can read this. Okay, cool. You think, plan, do, busy. Oh yeah, good. Super duper job. Wish you. Yep. Nah. Wow. How are you? Hello. Ideas. You are great. Stay cool. Happy. Me pretty people work. Do so good. Goal. You great people, success, let's do it.
Okay, thank you so much, Anil, for reading this out. Okay, now I have a question for all the participants. Now you'll have to share your views in terms of how Anil has done this. So what you're supposed to do is, you will have to go to this website, which is known as WooClap, WOOCLAP. Okay, so I request you to please go to WooClap, and you will have to give the feedback in terms of how did you like, how I actually you liked it, the way how Anil has spoken out the words. How did you feel? What was your feeling about it? So there are two options. How are you feeling about the activity after the activity? So this is the question. So I request all the participants to please log in to a visit to the website, WWCLAP. And you have to mention this particular code, which is AYFZBW. Okay. So you have to mention the, enter the code, and you have to select your responses.
Manish,
yes.
I cannot see any question on the screen.
I will just enable this, Fatima, just a moment. You can, but in the meantime, at least you can visit the WooClap website.
Yeah,
and you can I'll have to enable the poll. I'll just enable it. Can you see this now? At least, can you see some questions now? I've enabled it.
One question, how were you feeling after the activity?
So I want all the participants to at least mention this. I will be sharing the results as well with you.
I have answered.
Everyone has answered? Five participants have answered. I want all the participants to please answer this. Only five of you have answered it. I want maximum participation. There are 16 participants. I want all the 16 people to please take this up. This is very important. I'll let you know the reason behind it. If you face any difficulty, you can ask me in terms of how to go about this. All of you are done?
I can see some response in the chat box. I think 2-3 more people have done.
Yeah.
We can show the result. I think some people are not carrying the phone or something. So that may be
okay. Good. Fine. I think, yeah, 6 they have done this. Okay. Fine. So I have got a mixed response. I think I'll stop this over here. As you can see, all of you can see my screen, I believe. You can see that there are three, this is a 50-50 mixed response, wherein like 6 participants, 3 of them have said that they're excited about what, how Anil has.
I think you have to do a new share because we are only seeing your PPT screen right now.
Okay, one second.
Just do new share and then.
Can you see it now, ma'am? Is it visible? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I think I can see 9 participants. Wonderful. Yeah, 8. Fine. Yeah. 5 plus 4, 9. Okay. Okay, fine. I think I'll stop this. I think we'll stop it over here. And I'll see that how are you feeling after the activity? So you can see that there are 5 people who said they are feeling good about the activity and 4 people who said they felt boring about the activity. Okay. Not because Anil spoke like that, because the instruction was given to Anil that to speak the particular words in a very boring or in a very flat tone. So this is what it happens. So what is the learning out of this is? So whenever certain things are done, in a very redundant or in a very mundane manner, then probably, you know, it doesn't create any sort of resonance with the participants or with the audience. The same thing holds good when it comes to, like, you know, communication skills or public speaking. When we do not tend to, you know, modulize or like, you know, modulate our voice accordingly, we are not going to get the effective results or the desired results or the desired outcome that we are expecting. So for some certain people, it will be exciting. For some people, it will be a little boring because they will think that there is no flat, probably the tone is very flat, fairly flat, then probably the only problem is going to be like, it will not be able to create much impact on people. Now what I'll do is I'll just read this particular thing for all of you. I'll go back to the same screen now. I will just read this now, the same thing over here. I will read all these things as per the words which are mentioned here. So the first thing is, I'll say, just listen to me and follow me the way how I say that. I'll say it, yo, boom, okay, cool, you, think plan do, busy, miss you, love, super duper, good, oh yeah, yep, nah, wow, how are you, hello, yeah, ideas, you are great, right, wrong, me, so good, goal, let's do it, success, so good, work, people, great, you, creative, simple, stay cool, happy, wow, yep, nah. So can you see the difference, guys? Can anyone share this, like, in terms of the difference that you have felt like just now, how I spoke these words and how Anil did that? So any difference, could you find it? Any participant can share their views.
Can I share, sir?
Yeah. Yes.
It's the way you have just read this one with your full energy, right? With full energy. And you have shown here the expression of your voice, of your, you know, facial expression and your voice pitch.
Yes.
Like lower to higher and sometimes higher to lower. And we need to just match our voice with the word term
Yes.
In this way, when you speak, then that sounds like it actually it seems to be like that.
Exactly. Thank you so much, Anil. Anyone else would like to share their viewpoints? So what was the basic difference between how Anil spoke and how I spoke? Do you find any sort of difference in that?
Hi, Manish Shampa, yeah.
Hi, Shampa, yeah.
So the emotions behind the words could be felt.
Emotions behind the words could be felt. Thank you so much. Yes, that's true. Anyone else?
Yeah, there were rises and falls in your voice.
Rise and fall in my voice. Yes, that's absolutely correct. MK says you were leaving the emotions. Yes. Thank you so much, MK. That's true. I was leaving the emotions very much. So I think you are able to connect, right? What is the whole ideology of this particular session? So this is something like, you know, the VFIM. That is, what is it in for me? So this is what is there for you in this entire session package today. So wherein you will learn, I will teach you or I will train you in terms of how exactly you can have, like, you know, you can use such voice modulations in order to make this particular, even a dull statement also, very, very, very lively. So it's the ideology, the basic idea is, like, you have to just live by whatever you say. Okay? So let's proceed further. Yeah. So basically what happens is in training, like, you know, as trainers, we all know there is something called as WIIFM. That is, what is it in for me? But today I'm saying that what is it in for you? I've just changed that. What is it in for me? M to Y, that is me, for me to you. So let's see, what is it in for you today in this session? Well, a person is thinking that, okay, what is it in for everyone in the session? So let's see. Okay, so we have something. So what is this? Can anybody read this out, please? What is it?
Laughter and smile.
Laughter and smile. Okay, can anybody read the sentence properly and with a little voice modulation in it, involved in it? Can anybody say that? Can anybody read this, please? Try it out.
Yes, unwrap the gift and check out. Yeah.
Yay! Thank you so much. I can guess it is Ravi sir. Yeah. Thank you so much, Ravi sir. So let's unwrap the gift.
I'm thankful to you because you are still remembering my voice.
Yeah, Ravi sir. I remember you also. So thank you so much. So let's unwrap the gift and check out. Yay! Yes. So now, see, even it's not Christmas and still we have a gift to open. Now let's see what gift we have today. Wow, it's a lovely gift. Okay, who is going to open this gift now? I want anyone to open this gift. I want anyone, any of the participants to open this gift.
Whoever raised hand first.
Thank you, Swati ma'am.
Whoever raised their hand first and comes first in the race.
Yes. Okay, Saurav Kumar has raised the hand. Okay, Saurav, I think I'll probably, this is a virtual gift. So probably, yes, I think virtually you think that I've opened it for you. Thank you, Saurav. Okay. Wow, we have opened the gift. Now let's see what's there in the gift. What is this? What came out in multiple colors? What is this?
Voice.
It's voice. V-O-I-C-E. Voice. Wow, what is voice? So what is voice? Saurav, can you tell what is voice? I gave you this gift. So I gifted you and you got this voice. What is voice according to you, Saurav? What is voice? Can you tell me?
Saurav is happy with the gift.
Saurav is happy with the gift. Okay, Sampa has raised the hand. Sampa, yes, would you like to share? Yes, Sampa?
Yes, Manas. I would like to share something that I just read. Okay. It's not me, but it has really changed the way I think about, you know, voice and talking.
Sure,
so
sure.
It is that everything in human body that goes out voluntarily or involuntarily stinks.
Okay.
Okay. However, voice is something through which we express our true self, and we are in control of it, and we need to make it very sweet. And, you know, it should be as fragrant as the best flowers on earth.
Wonderful, Sampa. Wonderful. I think that's the greatest definition. That is the most beautiful definition that you have given. Okay. So let me unwrap this voice for you. So as a gift, since voice have come, let me see what voice is.
We can also say, Manas, that voice is the essence of our life, because without communicating, we cannot express, and without that, there is no life usually, you know. So we are of all are you know, blessed that we can speak. We have voice, right?
Yes, we can express our feelings, we can express our emotions, we can express anything for that matter. So human beings are blessed to have their own voice, wherein they can, like, you know, express out, they can speak out, they can shout out, they can, like, you know, do anything for that matter. But wherein, like, you know, if you see other animals, even though they have voice, but probably they cannot express certain things. So let's see now what exactly this voice is. So for V stands for variance, O stands for off, I stands for intrinsic, C stands for communication based on emotion. So this is voice. So as you have rightly said, as Sampa has rightly said, Swati ma'am has rightly said, that it's all the how is all the matter of, like, how we can express. We are all blessed to have been gifted with voice. Voice is just like a fragrance of a flower. Because of voice, today we are able to communicate effectively to people. We can express our feelings, we can express our emotions, right? Sometimes if you see, if you are angry, your voice is going to be completely different. If you are happy, your voice is going to be completely different. If you are excited, your voice is going to be completely different. So with each emotions, your voice varies, right? And that particular variation is called as what? What is that variation called as? Anyone can tell me that?
Tone.
Tone, okay. So when you speak in a different tone, what is that called as? Yes, I think Swati ma'am said that.
Modulation,
exactly. So it is called as modulation. So today's gift, since you've unwrapped this gift, we have seen, we have got voice, and also we have understood, you can see this something called as modulation. And you might be wondering, why this modulation is in different colors? So this different color indicates what? Can anybody tell me? What does this different color in the modulation indicates?
Pitch.
Pitch, okay. Any other things?
Variations.
Tones, okay. Yes.
Space.
Tone with modulation. Venugopal says, thank you so much. Venugopal, yeah.
We can also match it with the pace of the speed. What we
In one word, it is called as intonations, right?
Yes, it is called intonations as well. Yes. Jagdi says feelings. Okay. Feelings. Yeah. How does feeling, Jagdi, you are very close to it. How is feeling related to these colors? Feelings are also known as what? It's right here. The answer is right here. The E of it. It's emotions. Okay. That's the reason you can see here the tonality or the tonation or the intonation, whatever it is, different colors indicates different emotions of human beings. So when that's what I was giving the example, right? That when you are angry, you will be in a different emotional mindset altogether. When you are happy, you will be in a different emotional mindset altogether. So it indicates your emotion. That's the reason I put multiple colors here. Red indicates probably you are angry. Blue indicates you are happy. Pink indicates you are loving and caring today. So all these colors indicates your emotions. Okay. So are you all able to connect? Are you all with me in this? So this is about the voice modulation. So today we are going to learn about this voice modulation. Okay, I have a chat. I'll just check with this. Yeah, Venugopal says okay. Yeah, thank you so much, Venugopal. Yeah, Jagdish says true tone changes as per our mood, feelings, and emotions. Yes, very true, Jagdish. That is the reason why this modulation, I put it in different colors here, just to indicate our emotions, right? Because not every human being will be emotionally static, because every human being will have dynamic emotional sets or set of minds or emotional stages wherein the person has to react as per the emotion. According to the emotion which is driving him or her at that particular point of time. Okay, let's go to the next one. So this is my session today. So this is nothing but today we are going to learn this. This is what we are going to learn. This is essence of voice modulation in communication. So what is the essence? Why is this important? Why is tonality? Why is intonation? Why is speaking with emotion? Why is speaking with our heart is very important? So this is what we are going to learn, in this particular session. Okay. Now, before I could just proceed, there is a small question here. What is communication? Okay. Can anyone tell me what is communication? By looking at this picture, what do you understand by the term communication? Can anybody define what in this picture, what these people are doing? What is communication? Anyone can speak out for that matter. Anyone can speak out. You can unmute yourself and speak. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Communication here is just to deliver the message from one person to another.
Okay.
Conveying her message. Okay. That is communication.
Okay. Yeah, fine. Thank you so much. May I know your name, sir?
So my name?
Yes.
Maharjan, Anil myself.
Okay, Anil, yeah. Thank you so much, Anil. Okay, Venugopal says to express feelings. Ram Kulkarni says two-way speaking. Reena, thank you so much. Sumitra says exchange of information. Yes, that's true. Conveying in a proper way so the others can understand. Sheikh Aisha says, yes, true. Reena had raised her hand. Reena, would you like to say something?
Yes, communication is the way we express or we interact with each other.
Yes.
And communication is most important to say what we want to say.
Exactly. It's very important what we want to say, right? Jagdish says the way we deliver the message where the person understands clearly. Yes, very true, Jagdish, because that's how the feedback is going to come up. Otherwise, if there is no proper understanding or there is no clarity in communication, then you will not be able to get the right feedback. So let's just see the definition of it. Yeah. Expressing the ideas, feelings, and emotions. Yes, true. True, Ilyas. That's very true. Yeah, can anybody read this out, please? And I want you to read this out in a proper voice modulation, in a proper tonality. Can anybody try this out? Can anyone try this out, please? I would request maximum participation should be there through the voice chats itself, because this is just a voice modulation session. I think we can just experiment and we can learn how to tone our voice, how to chisel our voice properly, because then it is going to add more value to it. So my sincere and humble request to all the participants is to participate maximum through voice chat. Yes, Sampa has raised her hand. Yes, Sampa, would you like to try this out?
Reading? Yes, please. Okay, so it's all about imparting or exchanging of information by speaking, writing, or using of some other medium.
Okay, very nicely said. Thank you so much, Sampa. So I think you have just nailed it in terms of the voice modulation. So it's all about imparting or exchanging of information by speaking, writing, and using some other medium. So this is communication. So, and we all know that this is, and we all communicate, right? Day in, day out, we all do communication. Without communication, our life is so not done. It's so dull. It's so boring. If you imagine a person who is sitting lonely in the house and there is no one to talk to, imagine what sort of psychological disbalances or imbalances the person is going to undergo if there is no one to talk to. If a person doesn't have anyone to share his or her feelings with others, the person is going to be so mundane within himself or herself. That's the reason it's very important that exchanging of information is a mere requirement of human beings, because we love to exchange information. Sometimes, at times, when you might have seen also, I'll just give you a small example. Like sometimes when somebody is in a very angry mood or something, and when you go and talk to them that, hey, what happened here? Why are you so angry today? They'll say, I don't ask. My boss yelled at me and I do so much, but still he doesn't listen to me. You know, when they try to say it, other things, but they're trying to exchange the information. They're trying to exchange the emotion. It's not the information that they're trying to exchange. The people are trying to exchange their emotions. If you're feeling sad, you say, no, sometimes after somebody is very sad and once they exchange the emotion or information with somebody else, then they feel, oh my God, it's a sigh of relief. I'm feeling so relieved now because I've exchanged all the information with all of you now. So this is what happened. This is the part of communication. So when you communicate with someone, you actually tend to take out all your emotions from your body, mind, and you pour it out so that, you tend to become more and more relaxed and relieved. Okay. So this is how the communication is going, is considered to be one of the most helpful tool, basically for people who are stressed out, basically for people who are under depression. So communication ideally helps them a lot. So next is, now what is voice modulation? So since you have understood about communication, now let's see what is voice modulation. So can anybody read this out, please, for me? Anyone can try this out, please?
Yes, can I?
Yes, 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 please. Pradyumna, I think, Pradyumna, yeah. Right? Yeah.
Uh-huh. It's all about adjusting your voice according to various situations.
Yes, thank you so much, Pradyumna. So it's all about adjusting your voice according to various situations. Okay, so
some other person will speak in a different way, Manish. So maybe
that's what I was trying to give. I was about to say this already, Swati ma'am. So can anyone try this out in a little different voice modulation, the same sentence?
Can I?
Yes. May I know? Is it
Aisha Sheikh?
Yeah, Aisha. Yeah, Aisha. You can.
It is all about adjusting your voice according to various situations.
Yes.
See the difference.
So it's all about adjusting your voice according to various situations. Okay. So sometimes, when we are excited, as I already mentioned there, we are in a different tone. Yay! I'm so happy. When you are sad, I'm not in a good mood. When you are a very enjoyment, yay, I'm so excited, I don't know what to do. You can see the excitement, the tonality also changed. And with your tonality, your non-verbal communication, that is your body language also changes, your facial expression also changes, everything changes. So, your tonality is directly proportional to your body language also. Because the way your tonality is directly proportional to your body language, at the same time, it is also directly proportional to your mood also. What happens is whenever you are in a happy mood, so your tone is also going to be happy and also your body language will show the signs of happiness. The moment you are sad, your tonality is going to show that you are sad, and the moment your body language is going to show that you are sad or you're angry, whatever. So you can feel it out, right? So this is the power of voice modulation. Now there is an small activity. There's an activity which says, read the following sentence using voice modulation. So I want minimum three participants to read this in different tones. So any three participants. So let me see who is going to come first and is going to read this. Okay, Reena has raised her hand. Thank you so much, Reena. Reena, can you just read this out for me? For the entire class, probably.
Yes, yes. My mom is very hardworking, but now she is very ill.
Okay, fine. Thank you so much, Reena. Anyone else would like to try this?
Can I try?
Yes, yes, yes. Okay, two participants have raised their hands.
Okay, give them the chance.
Okay, okay. So who are they? I'm not able to see them. Swati, can you help me?
Yeah, Reena has already said. So Shampa has raised her hand.
Okay. Okay, Sampa has raised. Okay. Yeah, Sampa, you can please go ahead with this.
Thank you.
Well,
my mom is very hardworking, but now she's very ill.
Yes, wonderful, wonderful, Sampa. That's really nice. It's really nice. Okay,
yeah,
can we have
more.
One more participant?
Sumitra and Saurabh. So
Sumitra, okay.
Sumitra, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, Sumitra. Sumitra, can you please?
My mom is very hardworking, but now she's so ill.
Wonderful, Sumitra. Wonderful, great. Okay, Saurav, I think Saurav was there. He's raised his hand.
Yes, Manush. My mom is very hardworking, but now she is very ill.
Okay, wonderful. Okay, last but not the least, I think I'd just like to give the chance to Ravi sir. Ravi sir, can you please read this out?
Sure. My mom is very hardworking, but now she is very ill.
Wow, that's really nice. That's really nice. Thank you so much. So can you see the essence? Can you relate this with the previous statement, what I have made here? It's all about adjusting your voice according to various situations. Now, what was the situation here? What was the situation in this case? There are two situations here. One is like, the situation is, one is a very positive situation wherein I'm saying that my mom is a very hardworking lady. Wherein on the other hand, the next situation, immediate situation says that, but now she is very ill. Now my excitement will be at the peak when I say, my mom is very hardworking. Can you feel the excitement in me? But now she's very ill. Can you see? Can you identify? Can you analyze this? It went to the peak initially. Now it again dropped down the next day. So this is all about the voice modulation. So it's all about adjusting your voice according to the situation. So situation can be any situation. If it is a good situation, then probably your voice, your intonation, your tonality is going to be at a high pitch. And if it is not a good, if a situation is adverse, if a situation is demanding or challenging, then probably, yes, you are going to have, your voice modulation is going to fall apart. Yeah? Or it's going to lower down. It's going to be it will lower. So this is all about the voice modulation. Okay, now we have something called a share your learnings. Yes, now I think all of you have to again go to the same thing, that is same website, it's WooClap, WWOCLAP. Okay, and the code this time is voice, VOICE. You have to just enter the code voice. Okay, and the question for all of you is, mention any three importance of voice modulation in communication. So now that we have understood about communication, now that we have understood about voice modulation, so I would just like
Manish, you got on mute. Manish, you pressed mute. I think you have to unmute yourself.
Okay, I'm so sorry. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think the activity is known. So you'll have to again go to the WooClap website, www.wwoclap. And this time the code that you have to put is voice, VOICE. And I'll be just sharing the question now. You'll have to mention three learnings based on your, three inputs you have to share based on your understanding in terms of communication and voice modulation. Okay. Is my screen visible now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Just a moment. Yeah, just a moment. I'm sharing my screen. Is this visible now, my screen?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, I will take you to the, I will just enable this polling thing. Probably till then you can just, by the time you can just go to the website and you can just, type the word voice so that, you will be able to log in. Okay, Priya says, can you please share the website name on chat? Yes, I'll do that, Priya. I'll definitely do that.
The screen though.
It's in the screen, but still I'll share it again. Chat.
Voice is all caps, huh?
Yeah, voice is all caps, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome. I'm sharing the other screen here now. Okay, I started this. Can you see this now? Is it enabled?
Yeah, mention any three importance. Okay.
Yeah, of voice modulation in communication. Any three importance you can just mention. Priya says, is there a password? Yes, it is voice. V-O-I-C-E. Voice. Priya, you can type this voice and you will be able to get into this and you will be able to share the feedback.
Yes, done.
Done? All the participants have done this. Request all the participants to please participate. It is very important. I'll give one more minute to complete this. Fine. I think I'll just close this. Okay. Thank you all. I think I'll just close this. I think probably maximum we have seen that we have received tone, modes of speech, express emotions in a better way, situation, articulate better. All these inputs we have received. Yeah, I think that would work. So I think now you're able to relate it, okay, till now, that what exactly is this particular voice modulation all about and why this voice modulation is important in any sort of communication, right? Yeah, good. Good sharing of the inputs. Thank you so much. Okay, so I think maximum of you have mentioned in terms of importance of voice modulation communication, and that was great. Thank you so much for that. Now we are going to have another activity. So this is which is known as word stress activity. Okay, now stressing of words is very, very, very important. So at times what happens when we communicate, we tend to stress certain words just to ensure that, you know, that particular word is having some great impact or some great meaning. Okay. So let's have this activity now. I want any one of the participant to come up quickly for this. Any one participant can raise hand for this activity, please. Okay. Rina has raised her hand. Thank you so much, Rina. So Rina, so what you have to do is, so there'll be one sentence which will be popping now in front of you on the screen, and there'll be certain stress, certain words will be like this, how it is mentioned here as stress activity and all. So certain words or certain letters which will be little stretched out, you need to tune your tone also accordingly. Okay, Rina?
Okay.
Fine?
Okay.
Okay, so let's go about it. Yes. Let's start. This is the first sentence. Okay, Rina, you can proceed with the sentence.
Ati, three blind mice.
Okay, great. So the sentence is, a cat ate three blind mice. Right? Can you see the stressing of the words? Are you able to, can you relate this? How exactly we are stressing on certain words here? Okay, great. Thank you so much, Rina. Okay, who is going to come next? I want anyone to raise the hand quickly. Okay, Saurav Kumar has raised. Thank you so much, Saurav. Let's see. Yeah, so Saurav, this is the second sentence or statement for you.
Yes, Manish. So, a big fish in a small pond.
Okay. A big fish in a small pond. Okay, Sampa has raised her hand. So, Sampa, I am just going to give you the third statement here. Sorry, yeah. Sampa, you can just read it out.
You can just stress. I am so happy.
Yeah, that's true. I think Sampa, you are anyway, which was always happy, I believe.
Yes, I'm always happy.
I remember your laughter therapy challenge, that class. It was really nice, the laughter yoga.
Thank you.
So, thank you so much.
Sampa, by chance, are you from Bengal?
Yes.
Ah, that's fine. Easy for you.
Yeah, yeah. So even Ravi sir, even I am also.
Manish is also from Bengal, for that matter.
That's the reason people who are from Bengal, they are always happy. They are sweet, they love sweet, and they are also like, you know, they are very sweet.
Rasgulla.
Yes. Fine. Okay, who is going to come next now for the fourth one? Okay, there's someone in the chat. Let me see. Two participants raised their hands. Okay. Yeah. Who are the two participants? Swati ma'am, can you please help me out? Because I can see only two participants. I cannot see their names.
One second. So Shampa has already done. Sumitra has raised.
Yeah. Sumitra. Okay. Sumitra.
Okay.
Yeah, Sumitra. So here's a statement for you. Okay. Sorry. Yeah. I think you can read out this.
Yeah. Life is awesome.
Exactly. That's really nice. Life is,
thank you,
awesome. Fine. Okay, who is gonna come next? Two more. Okay.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, anyone else? Anybody else? There are two more. Quickly, participants. I want quick participation from your end.
Out of 15, only four are there. 11 more are still left.
Manas, yeah. Will pick up. Priya,
I will pick up now.
Priya, you have
that, that's why I minus.
Okay.
I minus three of us. I, you, and Manish.
two participants raised their hand. I think, yeah, Swati ma'am, can you please help me out with them?
Like Manohar, with the names, Manohar, you can unmute, please.
Yes, Manohar, yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just going to give you the fifth point. Yeah. So this is the fifth sentence. Manohar, this is for you, the fifth sentence.
I love training. I love training.
You love training. Do you really love training, Manohar?
Of course, yes. Always afternoon.
Okay. Thank you so much, Manohar. It was really nice. Okay. Last one. Anyone would just like to raise the hand?
Aisha, you please unmute yourself.
Yes.
Aisha, would you like to try the last one?
Yes.
Thank you so much. Yeah. I think, yeah, you can go about this.
Nature is so beautiful. Sorry.
Wonderful. Nature is so beautiful, right?
This is your day of talking.
So just got a hang of it. So this is what I just wanted to ensure, that certain words, but sometimes what happens when we speak certain things, you know, we stretch out on certain words. And basically, you will find this public speakers, whenever they do a lot of public speakings, whenever you watch a lot of TED Talks videos, no? TEDx videos, or TED Talk videos, you will find that the participants, the speakers, when they speak, no? They stretch on certain words, they stress certain words very much. So what is the whole reason behind this stressing? Why is it that, you know, stressing is required for certain words? Can anybody tell? Anyone can tell me this reason, that why exactly it is important for any participant to stress certain words while speaking? Why is it important?
To make them understand the importance of that word and the impact of that particular word, what we are really want to communicate.
Yes. Yes, exactly. Very, very rightly said, Ravisa. Anybody else would like to try this?
Yes, and at the same time, audience give a lot of importance to that particular word, what they are saying.
Yes, exactly. So audience is going to give importance to the particular word and impact. Yes, J.C. Siddharaju has raised his hand. Yeah. Can you please unmute yourself, sir? And can you please
share? Yes, sir. Yes, Manish.
Yeah.
Whenever we are in the public speaking platform,
yes,
to connect effectively with the particular audience, we need to stress some sort of words.
Yes. That's very important. So connecting with audience, creating impact, on the thing, on the particular saying, what you have to say. So that's very important. Yeah, there is one more participant who has raised the hand. Swati ma'am, I think you have to please help me out again.
Manish, I have to leave. Yeah, Shampa here. Manish, I have to leave. I'm so sorry. But Ravi is there. He will continue and will coordinate with you. Ravi, you are a co-host. You can please help Manish.
Yeah, I'll do it. Yeah, sure.
Sure. Yeah, thank you so much, Swati ma'am.
Thank you, everyone.
Yeah. Shampa has raised the hand again.
Yeah, Shampa. Yeah, I think you can continue. Yeah,
so I think voice modulation helps to drive a point or make a point or emphasize on the learning that you want to drive with the audience.
Exactly. That was it's the very, very, very most important thing, right? So whenever I'm training, whenever I'm conducting any session, or whenever I'm doing any sort of public speaking, the very most important thing for me is I need to create the right impact on the minds of the audience. Otherwise, what happens is if I only just come and just in a flat tone, I just say everything and I just walk off, then there is no impact. So why do you think that, there are certain, if you just watch the advertisements on the television, have you seen sometimes they say, the thumbs up, taste the thunder. If you say the word thunder, they just stretch it. They stress on the thumbs up, taste the thunder. They say that, right? So why do you say that? Why do you stress that word thunder is, you want to create an impact. They want to create an impact that, it tastes like a thunder, then I should probably try for it. Okay? So, see, this advertising industry uses all this, word stressing activities a lot, intonations a lot in terms of, it is catchy phrases and all. To advertise for the brand logo and everything, so they do that. So this is very important. And this is the real importance of the word stressing, how it is going to create an impact in the minds of the audience. Fine? Yeah. So I think we are going to proceed with the next thing, which is known as the six elements of vocal variety. Now, when we talk, when we speak, even in our voice modulation also, there are a lot of varieties. There's something called as vocal variety. So what are the vocal varieties? Let's just have a look at it. First is volume, or which is also known as loudness. So what is the volume? What is loudness? Can anybody tell me why volume is considered to be as one of the most important parameter while we speak? Why volume is important? Anyone can just can speak out.
To be heard, you have to be loud.
To be heard, you have to be loud. That's true. You have to be really loud, or you have to at least create an impact. To be heard, you have to be loud. To create an impact, you have to be loud, right? Otherwise, the message, you cannot showcase the message that you have to put, or you cannot just pass on the message that you have to actually pass on to somebody.
It depends upon the situation also, depends upon the job or the role.
Exactly. Depends upon the situation, the job, the role, the emotions that we carry, right? Each and everything. So I think all these things plays a major role in terms of this. Okay. Coming to the next one is known as pitch. Now, what is pitch? Can anyone explain me what is pitch? There's something called as rise and fall. What is the meaning of pitch? Anyone else can explain? Anyone can explain this?
How high or how low the voice is, and to express emotions?
Yes.
Like, sometimes when you're angry, you speak in a very high-pitched voice, isn't it?
Exactly. And sometimes whenever you calm down, you cool down, then probably your pitch is gonna fall, right? So which is like the way you try to express your thoughts or feelings, okay? It can take our at a rise shape or it can sometimes fall also. What is the next one? The next one is pace, which is rate. So what is the meaning of rate or pace?
Speed of speech.
Exactly. It is known as the speed of speech. Now, what happens is sometimes you might have encountered some people in the life who talks really very fast. I used to have one friend of mine who used to speak so fast, I couldn't understand what exactly he's trying to convey. Because he used to say something like that and just get away. So pace is very important. Now what happens is if I speak at a very faster pace, people would just lose their interest. They would just lose on like how exactly the pace is going and they will just lose on certain things. They will not pay attention to it, right? So I think pace is very important and the rate of speech is also very important. Fine. Yeah, J.C. Siddharaju has raised.
Yes, raised his hand.
Yes.
Manash, is this directly interconnect with the word per minute?
Exactly. It is interconnected with word per minute. Thank you so much, J.C. Siddharaju sir, for bringing up this point.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. What is the next one? The next one is pause. It's known as silence. What is the importance of pause? Why pause is needed in any sentence or any situation or at the time while we communicate? Why pause is needed? Why pause is important?
For the communicator to grab the point or to register a point before exactly. Moving on to the next topic exactly. Or sentence.
Exactly. It's like more of like, you know, digesting what you have just said it to me. Because sometimes what happens, if you speak at a very fast pace without any pauses, then what happens is sometimes I might miss out on certain important things that you would say, right? So it is adequately, if I just put certain pauses in between, then it becomes really interesting and it becomes really nice. Where you like, you know, you have some like, you know, you're putting a pause, then people will think, fine. You're allowing me some time to digest the content, what you have just shared with me. So you are just providing me some time to recollect and some time to consume the content, right? That is why the pauses are very, very, very important. And sometimes that's the reason why we have this comma, full stop, semicolons in a sentence. Just to ensure that your rate of or the speech or the rate like pace is not very fast. So you at least like, you know, have a halt. You at least stop where you have to stop, right? Next is resonance, which is known as timbre. So what is the meaning of resonance? Resonance. How can you relate voice with resonance? Can anyone say this?
It's a kind of a voice that comes out when which automatically shows that you actually are feeling whatever you are saying. The conviction in the thought that we are trying to express through words, through our voice, you know, it's the level of the voice or the vibration in the voice which actually helps to automatically convey the message. Or the essence or the importance or the depth of whatever you are trying to convey. I think that is resonating.
Yes, yes. You are very right, Sampa. That's the right thing. It's resonance is that. So it's nothing but the voice modulation. Suppose, for example, you might have seen whenever you are listening to music, suppose if you have a music player, you can see that whenever the voice is going up, down and on, so you can see there is a lot of resonance. No? The things will be moving up, moving down and on. So resonance is nothing but the way the vibes through which, you know, your voice is getting connected to someone. That is known as resonance. And that is a very important thing in terms of, you know, voice modulation. And last but not the least, the very important thing which is known as intonation. So what is intonation? What is the meaning of the term intonation? What is the meaning of the term intonation? Anyone can speak out? You can try what is intonation. It's pretty simple.
Actually, it is the rise and fall of the voice that when we speak. Sometimes we speak with a higher voice, sometimes we speak with the lower voice.
Exactly.
As per the importance of the speech that we are going to give, or on a particular way of speech that we are going to give. That's the intonation. That is, it's also called as the rise and fall of pitch of the sound.
Yes, it is also called as the rise and fall of the thing.
Manas, this is Shampa here. Just to add on to what Ravi sir is just saying, intonation, yes. The rise and fall is fine, but same thing when we say with a high pitch voice has a different meaning, and the same word, same thing when we say that with a lower voice has a different meaning. So that is also a part of intonation.
Exactly. So if you can see here, so intonation and pitch are interrelated with each other, right? So when I say pitch also indicates rise and fall, whereas intonation also indicates rise and fall. So what is the difference? There is a thin line between pitch and intonation. So pitch is something like we are just saying certain words, okay, in a rise or in a falling tone. But intonation is what nothing but it's a cumulative things of like the words, or it's a accumulation of the pitches. It's a accumulation of all the pitches which you are going to use in a particular sentence, right? This is called as intonation. So intonation can also be like, you know, high intonation, lower intonation, okay? So all those things are, you know, it is very much interrelated with the pitch. So a group of pitches altogether forms an intonation, you can say. So in a sentence, if there are multiple pitch that you are using, intonation is cumulative of that. Got it? So this is the difference between intonation and pitch. Fine. I think we'll just go to the next, proceed to the next thing. Okay, so now we have something called as fun activity. Okay, before that, I think I just had a chat. Ravi sir, can you help me out with that? Because it is not visible here.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Okay. Why don't you show Ram by example? Kulkarni. Yes. So Ram, we are just going to do this fun activity now. And in this fun activity, we are going to see how exactly we can use all the six things. Speech and intonation, yeah. I'm going to show it in this form of activity itself, no? Fun activity. So we have a fun activity now, and I want maximum participation in this particular thing. This is going to be really helpful. Okay, thank you so much. I will just quickly now go to another thing. One second. Stop sharing this. Okay, can you see my screen now, all of you?
Yes.
Okay. So what you have to do is, so here is something, this activity is, so here are certain sentences. As you can see here, so here there are some sentences here. Okay. So I will ask one by one of you to just come up and read the sentences. But the whole point is, so there is a blue sky, kind of a blue thing over here. So here I'm going to give you the instruction, in which instruction, as per the instruction, you have to read out this particular sentence. Okay. Then you can relate it with like what is speech, what is intonation, what is the volume, everything you can relate it with this activity. Okay. Ready? So who's going to come first for this? Who's going to take up this?
As usual, Sampa.
I don't mind.
Yeah.
Yes, Sampa. I think you can just I think Sampa, are you ready with this?
Yeah.
Can we proceed? Okay. Okay. So you have this particular statement here. So this particular statement, I'll show you what in which tone you have to read this out. Okay. So now can you see? Speak the sentence in an exciting tone. Now you have to speak this particular sentence in an exciting tone. Okay.
Okay.
Ready, Sampa? Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
We are not taking the test today.
Yes, wow, that's really nice. We are not taking the test.
Yesterday.
Yesterday. This is the exciting tone. Okay. Now, Sampa, can you tell me what was the intonation here? Was it a high intonation? Was it a low intonation? Where you have used the pitch, high pitch, low pitch? Can you tell me that? What exactly was it?
It was a high intonation.
Okay. And then where you have used the high pitch here? Which thing you have you used the high?
We are not. We are not taking.
Exactly. We are not taking is the high pitch. Yeah. Okay. Got a hang of it? So the entire sentence intonation was high, but the pitch here was more high on we are not taking. Because of this not taking the test today, we are very excited, right? So wonderful. Thank you so much, Sampa. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Raviji.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay, next, who is going to come next? Participants, I want maximum participation from your end. Yes, Reena, thank you so much.
Reena.
Okay. Reena, can you, you have this particular statement. Now I'll give you the situation. Now you have to read out as per the situation here. Okay?
Okay.
Ready, Reena?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So here you go. Speak the sentence in an angry tone. Okay, Reena. So now you have to speak this particular sentence in an angry tone.
We are going to play football today.
Okay.
We're going to play football today.
Okay. I think a little bit more angry. I think angriness should be there.
We are going to play football today.
Okay. Little bit more angriness.
We are going to play football today.
Okay. I think that sounds better. So, okay. Thank you so much, Reena. So, Reena, can you tell me, so was it a high intonation or low intonation and where the pitch was?
It was high and this was on going to play.
Going to play, yes. So angrily you said that yes, it was high intonation. When you are speaking in an angry tone, your intonation is going to be really high. And in that case, probably when you say I am going to do this, somehow I have to win the match. Then that itself is the stressing thing. So the pitch here is high. You're getting a hang of it, right? So this is how it is. Thank you so much, Reena.
We are going to play football.
Ravi sir, can there are two participants who have raised their hands.
I'll just let you know.
Yeah.
One is Siddharaju.
Yes.
Sid, please unmute yourself and speak.
Yeah, sir, I'm just going to give you the next statement here.
Yeah, please. We'll try
out. So this is please. That would be really nice. Will you? This is the particular statement here. Okay, can you see this on the screen?
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay. It's visible. Okay, now I'm going to give you the. So this is the this is the statement, and this is how you have to speak. So can you please speak in a sad tone the same statement here?
Will you sell my car?
Wow, that's really nice. I think you felt so sad. Okay. Now,
tune according to the situation.
Yes, Sampa.
Manas, this can also be done in a sad surprise tone.
yes, this can also. Would you like to try this, Sampa, in a sad surprise tone?
Yes. So, will you sell my car?
Yes, very good. So, I think now.
That's great.
That's on it. That's really nice. That's really nice. Okay. So now can you tell me that what exactly is the intonation here, whether it was a high intonation or it was a low intonation?
It's a low intonation.
Very good. It was a low intonation.
Will and what, sell.
What was the pitch? Where was the pitch?
My.
Will you sell my car? Obviously, like you sell my car. So when you say that, the pitch is low. Okay. Great. Wonderful. Okay. Who is going to come next? Okay, JCC.
Priya Srinivas has given a
thumbs.
I don't know for what she has given the thumbs up. She wants to take part.
Yeah, Priya, I think you can please speak if you want, if you wish to. This is an open forum. This is actually, in fact, it's for everyone. I request maximum participation from your end. Anybody else? I think JC Siddharaju sir had raised. Okay, Aisha had raised her hand.
Yeah, Aisha.
Yes, I'm here.
Yes.
Yes, Aisha ji.
Yes. Yes, Aisha. So this is the statement. Okay. I'm going to give you the situation now. So this is the situation for you.
Wow.
So you have to speak this particular sentence in a romantic tone. Okay.
Yeah. I will try.
Yeah, sure.
Imagine that you are in a park.
Okay. Yes, okay, I'm in that visualization mode now. Let's go. I didn't say that we should go.
Wow, that was really nice. Wonderful, Aisha, wonderful. So Aisha, can you tell me what was the intonation? Which intonation was it? What is the high? Was it a low? Was it a moderate?
I was in romantic mood, so I forgot.
You forgot that, yeah.
So you virtually entered into a park.
Okay, nice. Okay, and what was the pitch, Aisha, about this? Can you just relate? Where did you focus more?
It was a slow pitch.
Yes, it was a very slow pitch. And I think you focused more on the didn't, right?
Yes, absolutely. Wonderful.
Thank you so much. I think Vishwanath sir had raised the hand. JC,
yeah.
Can we just give an opportunity to JC sir for the next one?
Yeah, sure.
Hi, Unish.
Yeah, hi sir. So I think this is the statement. I'll just give you in the tone in which you need to speak. Okay, so you have to speak the same sentence in a singing tone. You have to sing and say the sentence.
I love your mother's cooking.
Wow, that's so nice. So I love
mother's cooking. Yeah,
wonderful. I think everyone loves their mother's cooking. And probably I miss my home food, my mom's prepared meals. I really miss them. Probably I would just try this probably. This is something that... It's very fascinating for me. I just love this. I love your mother's cooking. So this is something like, you know, it's a singing tune. Wonderful. Great. I think with this, we'll just close this. We'll get back to the content part now. Yeah. Is my screen visible now to everyone?
Yeah. Visible.
Yeah, it's visible.
Yeah. Thank you so much. I think I had a question. Okay. So Ram Kulkarni, sir, I think have I answered your question? Are you able to understand the difference now between pitch and intonation? Ram Kulkarni, sir? If you've understood, you can just update in the chat box, or else if you want to speak, you can just speak also by unmuting yourself. Fine. I'll proceed with the next part. So I think this was the fun activity. Did you all enjoy this activity?
Very much, sir.
Yeah. Really enjoyed. Thank you so much. Okay. So now coming to the final thing. So what have we learned? So these are the things that we have learned. Okay. Yeah, I have a chat. Okay. So first is, we have understood the importance of communication. I think we have learned here in terms of how exactly communication plays a major role. Okay, because we have discussed that probably initially, that, you know, how communication can actually help us to express our ideas, emotions, feelings, beliefs, and everything. We have also learned how to express our emotions. I think in the fun activity, I think we have all expressed our emotions, right? We sang, we spoke something in a singing tone, we spoke a sentence in an angry tone, we spoke a sentence in an exciting tone. I think so many things. We also seen something, we have observed something on how stressing on words is going to be really helpful. And we have also done some live examples of on how we can stress certain words. Okay. And creating an impact on audiences by waves of voice. I think, yeah, that was there. I think initial stage, if you remember, when I asked Anil sir to read it in a flat tone, and then I asked your feedback, I think it was a 60-40 ratio that had come. But again, when I just had, I read it as according to the words in my own voice modulation way with all expressions and everything, then probably the audience gave a different feedback, right? So I think this was what, okay, sir. So Mitra, thank you so much. See you again. Yeah. So I think this was what is all about creating an impact in the waves of the audience. So I think these are all the major key takeaways. Any other key takeaway anyone would like to share apart from these four, I think they can share. They are open to share this. If you have anything else you want to share, would you like to share in this forum? Apart from this four things that is mentioned here, any other thing that you have learned today, something which is new and you have learned something that you have understood something new, you can share in this forum. Anyone?
Fun at learning. Really enjoyed a lot.
Yeah, thank you so much, Aisha. Thank you. Even I really enjoyed conducting the session for all of you. Yeah.
Enjoyment cannot be one way, right? It's always two way.
It has to be two way, exactly.
Yeah.
Manas, thank you for the wonderful session, actually. It was learning, yeah.
Welcome. It's my pleasure completely. Thank you so much, Sampa. Yeah, I think with this, I'd just like to close that there's a famous quote by Dave Willis who says, like, your tone matters as much as your words. So it's not only the words that you, it's not only, that is the most important thing. So it's not like, you know, what you speak. It's all about how you speak. So that's very important. So this is the one simple thought which you'd like to leave it on all of you to just ponder over, that always remember. So sometimes what happens, we tend to only speak, but we should also understand that when we speak, the most essential part is, like, it's not about, you know, what are the things that we are speaking. Is we can speak 10 things, 15 things, 20 things to certain people, but how we put across the things, how we create an impact, how we make people to consume the things, that's pretty important. Okay. So, any questions if you have, I think I'm open to take questions. Any questions?
From thank any you, Monash.
Manas?
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
Thank you, Monash, for
Welcome. It's my pleasure.
How to blend with the audience with the different tone models and the techniques. And only one thing at the last, I would like to know from your side.
Yes, sir.
For maintaining the mic distance,
okay,
is there any perfect practice technique? Because sometimes what happens, that will vibrate with the speaker and the vibration, and it will reach the audience in a different level.
Yes.
Sometimes it's clear, sometimes it's not clear.
Yes.
And the hissing sound, the breathing sound is also reflecting at the receiver end.
So whenever you are... Yeah. So thank you for asking this question. So whenever, like, you are holding the mic, I think you can just hold it at some amount of distance. Suppose if, say, this is the mic example, I'm showing my sanitizer itself, I'm sorry. So
okay.
You can just hold, minimum, this much distance would be fine. I don't know exactly I won't be able to tell you the measure, but I think you have to, like, test it. That's the reason testing is very important. So once you do it, you test it before you actually speak out to the audience. And once you do that, you can see the voice, you can see the echo level and everything. Post that, I think you can start and go ahead, proceed with the audience part. But a good amount of distance is very much required.
Normally it says 6 to 9 inches away from your mouth,
yeah,
to avoid your breathing.
Breathing thing, yes. 6 to 9 inches.
Sometimes what happens is that we hold it very close to the mouth also. To express a certain funny or humorous things, or making the audience laugh loudly or something, or making some mimicry type of thing. Otherwise, in any training session or any public speaking, the best way to adopt is to keep the mic at between 6 to 9 inches distance from your mouth, depending on the pitch of your sound and also your tone, which is an inbuilt one. If someone asks me to speak in a lower voice, I will not be able to make it because my voice is as hard as it is. So that's the where you have to adjust it. That's why we say it is 6 to 9 inches from the mouth.
Okay. Thank you. I was not aware about that. That I know that there's some distance should be there, but I was not aware that it has to be 6 to 9. So I was not aware of that. So I learned it from you. Thank you so much, Ravi sir. Yeah, I think Siddharaju sir has raised his hand. Yes.
Oh, it's clear.
Siddharaju sir, before I could just take your question, I will just answer to this question. I think, thank you so much, Venugopal sir. And I think Manohar has asked me to share the PPT. So Manohar, I will not be sharing the PPT content rather. I have prepared Ready Retina. So I will
thank you.
Ready Retina with all of you in the group. I'll ask Swati ma'am to share the Ready Retina with all of you in the group.
We always do it. We always do it. By the end of the day, you will get the recording as well as the
Ready Retina.
Right? Okay. Not to worry about that.
Yeah. Yes, Siddharaju sir, I am up to take your question now. Yes.
Yes, sir. Oh, that is the only thing which I...
Okay.
Ravi sir has given explanation completely.
Okay.
That was nice. Thank you, Manash. Yeah. Thank you, Ravi Kumar sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And last but not the least, I think...
Yeah, one more lady voice I could hear in between. It was getting clashed with... Mr. JC, so may I know who was that female who was talking? Because it was
Aisha. She's also raised.
Aisha. Okay. Aisha, can you please?
Yeah, Aisha, yes, Aisha. Yeah, tell me.
Yes, sir, I already told that session was wonderful. Just, I want to know now from 1.5 hour, we did good practice and the session went well live. So we trainers, if we want to work on our intonation and all, is there any good tips and tricks so that you can tell us?
You have to just practice, Aisha. That is the only thing. You have to practice and practice, because communication, voice modulation is something like, you know, you have to try out different things. You have to experiment different things. You have to read a lot. You have to understand. You have to Google. You have to just go to Google. You have to find out that how exactly the certain words are being pronounced. Okay. Mm-hmm. So these are the ways, because I ideally do that. And you tend to speak to a lot of people, try to stretch certain words and see how it works, how it sounds.
Okay.
And this is the only way how you can improvise.
To add on to this, Aisha, I would give you a very simple tip to maintain your intonations. Is that you write a script of a conversation between two or three people, right?
Okay.
With different feelings and different circumstances. And then practice it as if you are doing a mono acting.
Yes.
You do it as a mono acting in front of the mirror and see the expressions in your face, see the intonation of your voice, and that will give you a very good practice.
Yes.
Thank you. Aisha, one more thing, just I would like to, since you have asked this for thing in the forum, try to converse in English to the maximum possible extent.
Yeah.
Okay. So ensure that your mother tongue, even though your mother tongue or the your language or the native language, what you speak at home, if you can speak that, but at the same time, you can ensure that it should be 80-20. So 80-20 is nothing but, like, you know, you speak 80% of English and 20% you keep your
MTI.
Your own mother tongue. So if you do that, no, the more you converse in English, the more you can sharpen and hone your intonation or communication skills. That is the best way. I think.
Definitely. Thank you so much.
And watch a lot of TED Talks videos. I think that is, you will be inspired by those videos. Mark my words.
Yes,
watch videos from Goalcast, from TED Talks, from Toastmasters International. I think these are the three forums. You can just see and you can replicate them. You can take some good ideas in terms of how they are doing. You can mirror them. So, you know, and you can understand, okay, if they are doing this, let me also try this. So something as such. You keep learning by once you start observing people. No? You keep
learning from them. Definitely, we'll do that. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Welcome. Yeah. So I think the last part is the feedback thing. So I think the people who are there currently, I request you to again go to WooClap and please share the feedback in terms of how was the overall training session being conducted. So I just want to just have it for my reference. That is the whole ideology. So request you to just share the valuable feedback in terms of this. So I think once we're done with the feedback, then I think we can close this. This was the last slide. So I'm just requesting all of you to please go to the book lab again. So this is the feedback thing. So can you see my screen now?
It's very small.
It's very small. One second.
Yeah. Just put it into slideshow mode.
Can you see this now?
Yeah.
Yeah. So these are the four parameters: excellent, good, average, poor. So I think you can share your feedback. You can go to ooklab.com and you can type this code, that is KYPTEP, and you can please share your valuable feedback.
What is the code, sir?
It's KYP, capital KYPTEP.
Okay.
KYPTEP. I will mention this in the chats as well. Also, it would be great if you can just drop a WhatsApp message also in terms of the feedback. I think that would be fine. KYPTEP. Only two of them have shared the feedback. Can everyone, can all please share the feedback? There are 10 participants. 5 of them have shared. Anybody would like to share this? Further, I think I'll close the session now in some time. Okay. I think I'll close this poll now. Thank you, Aisha. Thank you all. Thank you so much.
Yes, Monash, we sent the feedback.
Yeah, thank you so much, sir, for that. So I think with this, I think I would like to close today's session. So thank you so much. Thank you all for joining. And thank you for your lovely feedback. I'm really blessed and glad, and hoping to conduct more sessions in the future, and hoping to see such lively audience again. So thank you so much once again. Thank you, Ravi sir. Thank you, Swati ma'am.
Thank you, Manash, for again delivering a wonderful and awesome session over here.
Thank you so much, sir.
My pleasure. To be there with you as when it is available, right?
Sure.
It was really a wonderful session, and thank you all the participants, those who had taken part. All the 18 or 19, those who have missed, my thanks for them also. It will be there. So with all this, I'm Ravi Kumar on behalf of Tennis Club signing off. Thank you all once again. We'll meet.
Thank you so much.
As early as possible.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you all. Have a great day.
Thank you. Thank you, Manasji.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you.